is a very wonderful platform for us, and we'll collaborate with you and understand each your condition.
It's really, really wonderful. I never thought I would be having such exposure towards global things.
The roadmap that you have put forward is excellent at the moment.
First of all, thank you very much. Quite frankly, it has been very, very informative for a person like me to, you know, to, I would say, re-live in the trajectory of entrepreneurial experience. What you have laid down is very, very important. My group of companies has got a variety of products, and which are various at various stages. So definitely the structure which you have given out is to on classifying the, basically it's like seeing ourselves in a mirror.
Ayyappa Das, founder and director of Avashan Go Global Limited, along with my founder, Dr. Aziza Jalaluddin. She's now in Singapore. I am fortunately or unfortunately in India, in Kerala. Who are we? What are we? What is that we can offer? And how that we can join in this journey together? So before that, Namaste Bharat. Are a good team connected with us, platform connected with us, like many other platforms all around the globe. Actual business collaborations are different, and really collaborating in the platforms to support businesses are different. So these two are two different perspectives. And that is how, when Namaste Bharat Purnima Ji approached us for being part of this journey, so then we offered ourselves for 4 sessions. So that is way one is for the African countries through Mauritius. The second one, Malaysia, Singapore, and Indonesia. The third one into US and Europe market. And the last one into the funding platform. So that is how we collaborated for 4 sessions. And through the 4 sessions, we are here in discussing further of what next for us. Okay, so this is what a basic summary of how we collaborated and how things are taking shape. What next? After the Namaste Bharat event, where we were collaborating. Of course, Namaste Bharat event is a continuous process. We position ourselves as Go Global Business Accelerator. Everybody are aware about the incubation activities, incubators, startup supporting activities and all. We deal with SMEs, grown-up businesses. In the sense, the business can be or may be a startup, but whereas the mindset of the business owner should not be a startup. It means that the business owner should have an expertise, even if the business is a startup. So we deal with only the SMEs. And through the SMEs, the main focus area of our Shine Go Global Business School is educate, align and expand. We educate people, align together, understanding into the same level as what the global standard expectations are in any form of business, and then support in expanding. We have shareholders, partners, associates all around the globe. We have in all major cities in India. We have in Malaysia, Singapore. We have in US. We have in Australia, New Zealand. We have in ASEAN countries. We are connected with Mauritius, taking forward to African countries, in Indonesia. So our connections, all of those things, whatever I'm speaking about, the network is a network, have been through my partner, Dr. Aziza Jalaluddin. Just browse on Dr. Aziza, and you will know who she is, what a person she is. So she had been into the transformation industry for the last 2 decades, and all the connections what she had been able to bring on board is almost 70%. It's hers. Evolution on every other day is vital for your business development, which Asians haven't still realized to the best. And that is where we are at the back end when compared to the Americans and the Europeans in business. And now among the Asians, we cannot add Chinese to the Asian part. They are now a superpower separate. So when you look at it, we Indians and the ASEAN countries, though we have huge resources for us to position ourselves as the real future along with the Asian countries, are struggling a bit. I need to mention this word. We are struggling a bit, not able to scale our business to the next level of growth. What are the real phases of struggle we undergo? We are into a traditional model of business. When you need to scale up, you need to understand what is it really required. So that is where we never bother about the education part, the global business education, which is very, very vital in structuring a business, in running a business. Let it be the financial intelligence, marketing intelligence, let it be the capital mechanism part, let it be structuring a business, the various departments, the digital transformation, and all those things have to really undergo a massive change when you want to go global. And when going with the word going global, I want to make every one of you very clear. Don't think that going global means going out of India. India itself is a country of countries. It's the business education part, our first enabler. The second part is investor relationship management, the funding part. So we are good in creating a financial roadmap with a clear exit strategy, not necessarily IPO.
That is for people to realize that funding is important. And at the same time, something that we overlook is how you structure your funding. You know, there's so many ways it can be done. So we will support you in that, you know, for moving forward. So when you think of funding, it's creativity, actually. So funds are everywhere. Funds are available. It's how you're going to present it. And that's where, you know, there's a lot of dynamics around it that we will be able to support you based on your business and based on your model.
We take you as far as you want to go. If you people are satisfied with this 1 hour session and you have got some tidbits out of it and you say that, oh, with this I can work, with this I can take forward my journey, thank you very much. And if you think that after that, no, we wanted to learn much more from you, you're most welcome. You want to be part as a partner with us, most welcome. You wanted to set up and work along with us from Singapore, most welcome. Gone are the days in America. Gone are the days of Europe. It is Asia. If India has to compete with other Asian countries, we need to rewire ourselves. We need to get into a process of re-engineering ourselves. If we are prepared for tweaking our strategies in businesses, I'll tell you, next 5 years to 10 years are going to be the biggest giant leap for the Indian companies.
We're going to look at three areas that most companies are in. So we are looking at you in three different categories. The first group of people are no funding and they are small in organization. They are more of the MSMEs. The second one wants to start going global and they may or may not have funding. These two groups of people are there. I know sometimes they have grown big enough and they are ready for growth at the next level. So they may or may not need funding.
Third one, you already have started exporting. You need much more connections, much more countries with funds, with more funds. So these are the three different parts. So these three different parts can be really structured. And everybody will agree with me that all the three cannot come into the same platform together for us to share because your priorities will be different. Every one of you will be receiving a Go Global checklist. We will be sharing you a document called as Go Global checklist. So in the checklist, you may have to furnish certain materials, certain informations. So we will understand about your businesses so that in the next level of meeting, it can be much more in a purposeful, productive way, focusing on what your requirement is. So you need to share about your business model, okay, the current business model, and what is your expansion plan? What is your expansion plan? The financial target, how much in next 2 years, 3 years, or 5 years? What is your expansion plan? What is your budget? What is your annual budget in your business? The fourth one is, how big and efficient is your team? What is your team size? So it can be the total team size. You can even categorize into the board of directors, the management team, and the real working team, if you have so. If not, the total team size. Don't add the outsourced parts. So if we say the team size, the efficient team size, they should be with you 24/7, the working team. And then how much funds do you need? What is your requirement for funds? Is it an equity funds or a debt funds? We can support you with debt funds, of course, with collateral. It can be for a minimal period with the collateral as the equity stake, and after that it is exit. So we can come out with various models of funding also. I'm repeating it in the global checklist. Go global checklist. One is, what is your business model? What is your expansion plan? That is a financial target. Third one is, what is your budget? Fourth one is, how big and efficient is your team? And fifth one is, how much funds do you need? Whether it is equity or debt. So please share with us those details, which will facilitate us to organize the structured meeting of these three different categories very soon. How do you want to get connected? Is it simply a buyer-seller? I'll tell you, we are not interested in that space. Not even for us, or even we don't want any of our partners and associates simply to get into buyer-seller part, because this is like this. Anytime we can slip off. If somebody is going to get a product, a 2 rupees lesser than what you offer, you lose a customer. That's not business. And our business model, our partnership is always like this. Very firm. And if at all you want to break your partnership, you need to really cut your wrist, which either other party will not wish to do so. So I'm interested in him and he is interested in me. So the partnership is like this. So it is inseparable. So this is what the partnership which is required for the current day businesses. Very, very essential, my dear friends. So what is that? How do you want to collaborate? So business houses, we need to really gear up our business model, restructuring into how it is required. We can create businesses with various communities, connections, what we possess. So the days forward after Diwali is going to be really energizing, empowering for every one of us in businesses. And let's take forward this journey in a very divine guidance as what we feel, because every one of us feel that whichever community you belong, there is a superpower above us. So he decides on what to do and what not to do. If not the divine intervention, definitely we could not see a possibility of 20 plus people over here, and we could have the opportunity to share with you. And definitely we will take it forward in a very committed way. And I'll tell you, we are into the Go Global platform. We are a very transparent organization. Don't hesitate to ask us even the dirtiest question. I'm mentioning it, even the dirtiest question, what you have in mind. We don't have any hesitation. We have the patience because we are handling hundreds of people every month all around the globe. So we know what are all the general questions come. We can answer it. We have the patience and the maturity to handle it. At the same time, once we get into the partnership, once we start working together, by the time, the clarity should be more than 100%. So that is what we in Chang Go Global, we firmly believe, because our ecosystem is from Singapore. And if you know, Singapore is a place where 100% compliance. Anybody who do wrong cannot enter Singapore. And anybody who did wrong in Singapore cannot come out of Singapore. And that is why the whole globe treats Singapore as the financial hub.
I know all of you have a lot of questions in your mind, like Mr. Harshal has also put up. We just need to tell you that because that three categories, even like what you asked, you want to have a global partner. Is it you want to set up company in Singapore or you just want to trade? So as we mentioned very clearly, we are not middlemen. So we will structure it according. So we are customized model, if you understand what I mean. So depending on your business, depending on the kind of scalability of your business, we may tell you that I don't think we can support you. We may even tell you that, right? So it all depends on your business, your clarity. The kind of question just now Aipaji mentioned, I don't know whether you wrote it down, about what is your plan? You need to tell us. For example, you say you want a global partner. What is the financial number you're looking at to grow it? And what is it that you are looking for? Then we can tell you whether we can do it or not. If we are going to do it, how it works. Do we charge a consultation fee? Maybe, maybe not. Do you have, do you take stakes? We don't take commission upfront. We don't do the middleman matching with commission. We do a partnership, which means we are going to be working with you, for you, as in partnership with you. So that means we go into profit sharing instead of commission. So there's a very, very flexible way of working with us. It's the soul of your business. When we are able to brand it with what, you know, happened to my work, like I would say my work when I say, because after IFRG came in, the soul of my business got structured. So that's how it became louder for everybody to see clearly what I was talking about. And our vision, I just want to maybe conclude it by telling everybody, is to see Indian businesses go global. This is like a passion that's been in us. And since 2002, I'm breathing and dreaming of this. Going to China to speak to Chinese people about coming to India. I mean, I don't know how many people does that. And at that time, I've been traveling around. We were going to US in spiritual parliaments, sharing about the power of India and all of that. So our passion is for Indians, making India, if you call it, or the Indian voice to be heard loudly around the world. And if we can go in a structured way, people will hear us. And I'm so passionate about this, that Indians are the most intelligent people in the world. This is told to us by our American teachers. That's the kind of people that we hang out with. They told us that Indian people are the most intelligent people in the world. They just need to get some ideas on how to structure and brand themselves. And we are a voice. We have the real soul in our country. That's where we need to bring in structure and system. I tell you, we are a force nobody can come near to. There's so much of room to grow and so much of work to be done. So let's stay together and continue this conversation in a more structured way. And we have, you know, people in the space to guide us as well. So we're really looking forward to the next level of conversation with everyone.
Hello, sir. Hello, Ayyappa, sir. Hello, Aziza, ma'am. Wonderful meeting with you. And I hope we will be a great business deal with you. And my business plan is global level. Art Make in India is a collaborate with a small medium artisan. I am also artist since 25 years in this field. And a very huge experience on that field. What is the lacking? What is the packing? What is the marketing? So it's a very wonderful platform for us. And we'll collaborate with you and understand each your conditions.
Thank you. Thank you, Aziza ji, and thank you, Ayyappa ji. It's wonderful to see both of you being together for 3 years. I guess you just celebrated 3rd anniversary. The roadmap that you have put forward is excellent at the moment, but obviously there is a lot more personal one-on-one required that I may get connected with you.
First of all, thank you very much. Quite frankly, it has been very, very informative for a person like me to, you know, to, I would say, re-enliven the trajectory of entrepreneurial experience. What you have laid down is very, very important. My group of companies has got, you know, a variety of products and which are various at various stages. So definitely the structure which you have given out is to on classifying the basically it's like seeing ourselves in a mirror, that which of the mirror which we belong to, you know, that whether it is blue, green or whatever, pink, and thereafter because it's basically from the side of participant, is that it will help us self-actualize that where are we and what is it that we want from this association? And then you as the let's say the soft partner or the service partner or whichever way, you know, a classification or the which is going to get the partnership, is that you don't want it simply transactional. You want it as a to become a stakeholder, whether by a direct stake or by otherwise, in the journey of the participant to take their companies, whether global, whether regionally. Maybe a company which has never done exports or has done some exports, they want to go regionally, or a company which is slightly more matured, some companies like us, who would like to expand their footprint across co-participants, you know, speaking from their side, please have funding in place. And, you know, whether it seems imminent or it doesn't seem imminent, it is like the blood which runs, it is like the air you breathe. People say money is not important. Money is very, very important. And nothing can move into this. And take the advice and, you know, and don't take me as I'm, speaking for global, is that prefer equity as to debt. In the stage of businesses which we are in, it is best to have part equity and have a permanent partner rather than have a, you know, transactional partner. Once you grow very big and can service the debt and, you know, from your cash flows, fine, take debt. But otherwise, stay away from debt as far as possible.
It is lots of learning for me. I'm still letting things to go inside my brain and, you know, analyze what to think, how to strategize, and how much I can really, you know, it's really, really wonderful. I never thought I would be having such exposure towards global things.
It's the soul of your business. When we are able to brand it with what, you know, happened to my work, like I would say my work when I say, because after IFRG came in, the soul of my business got structured. So that's how it became louder for everybody to see clearly what I was talking about. And our vision, I just want to maybe conclude it by telling everybody, is to see Indian businesses go global. This is like a passion that's been in us. And since 2002, I'm breathing and dreaming of this. Going to China to speak to Chinese people about coming to India. I mean, I don't know how many people does that. And at that time, I've been traveling around. We were going to US in spiritual parliaments, sharing about the power of India and all of that. So our passion is for Indians, making India, if you call it, or the Indian voice to be heard loudly around the world. And if we can go in a structured way, people will hear us. And I'm so passionate about this, that Indians are the most intelligent people in the world. This is told to us by our American teachers. That's the kind of people that we hang out with. They told us that Indian people are the most intelligent people in the world. They just need to get some ideas on how to structure and brand themselves. And we are a voice. We have the real soul in our country. That's where we need to bring in structure and system. I tell you, we are a force nobody can come near to. There's so much of room to grow and so much of work to be done. So let's stay together and continue this conversation in a more structured way. And we have, you know, people in the space to guide us as well. So we're really looking forward to the next level of conversation with everyone.